Assalamu alaikum, my dear students of Amanullah College and all the viewers. Welcome to my online class. Before going through my speech, I want to know how are you all? I hope you are hale and hearty by the sympathy or lenity of Allah. And I am also well. At first, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to all the students of class 11 and 12. My thanks are also extended to all of my students and viewers who have participated or joined on my online classes regularly. Dear learners, you know, I have already discussed 9 vocabularies in my previous classes, and that were cross-test with clues and without clues. In the meantime, you have already memorized it and also recollected it. Today, I want to discuss a vocabulary that is cross-test without clues number 10. Cross-test without clues number 10 that I have already written on your whiteboard. Dear learners, please go through the text and read the passages very carefully. From the very beginning of this close test without clues, you will see filling the blanks with an appropriate word in each gap, or filling the gaps using suitable words. You know it very well. Dear students, point to remember that there is no tangible or specific rules to solve the problems of this vocabulary chapter. But the same rules will solve both close test with clues and without clues. You have to choose the word according to the context or theme of the passage. According to the rules or patterns or meaning of the sentences, you will have to select the right words to fill in each gap. Okay? Let us analyze the sentences very carefully and let us start first. Beauty is easy to appreciate but difficult to define. Beauty is easy to appreciate but difficult to define. We know it. If we look around, we will discover beauty in dash objects and sights, in nature, in the dash of children, in kindness of a stranger. In the first sentence, there is no gap. But in the second sentence, we'll see number A and B are two gaps are seen. Before gap number A, a preposition in is used here, and after the blank part, a noun form object is also used here. Dear learners, we know in the medium of preposition and noun, there will be a meaningful adjective form. In the middle of preposition and noun, there will be a suitable or meaningful adjective form. Because adjective modifies the noun, you know it very well. According to the context, according to the meaning of the sentence, the suitable adjective will be pleasurable, inanimate, etc. For the blank number A, the answer will be pleasurable. Besides this, we can also use inanimate etc. And rest part of the sentence and sights in nature, in the dash of children, in kindness of stranger. Before gap number C, before gap number B, an article the is used here. And we know after article there will be a noun form. If we analyze the sentence vividly, we will see before blank part an article the is used here, and after blank part there is also a preposition of. And we know in the middle of article and preposition there will be a noun form. In this sentence, for expressing love, because sights in nature, objects and sights in nature in the dash of children. In this sentence, for expressing love, L-A-U-G-H, for expressing love, the meaningful noun will be laughter, a smile, or naughtiness. So, for the blank number B, the answer will be laughter. Beside this word, we can also use a smile, naughtiness, N-A-U-G-H-T-I-N-E-S-S, naughtiness, etc. And the sentence is, if we look around, we will discover beauty in pleasurable objects and sights in nature. In the laughter of children, or in the smile of children, in kindness of a stranger. But next sentence, but as to define, we run into dash, full stop. If we analyze the gap number C, before gap number C, into a double preposition is also used here. A double preposition into is also used here. And we know after preposition there will be a meaningful noun form, and it also act as a noun phrase. You know it very well. In the form of noun phrase, after preposition, there will be a noun form. In this sentence, for expressing problems, because but asked to define we run into dash. It's a problem for expressing problems. Difficulties is an appropriate word for the gap. So the blank number A, the answer will be blank number C, the answer will be difficulties. And the sentence is was asked to define we run into difficulties. Next sentence, does beauty have an independent identity? Does beauty have an independent identity? This is an form of a interrogative sentence. To make up the demand or meaning of the sentence, does beauty have an independent identity? Does beauty have an independent identity? Is it dash or relative? There is no gap in this sentence, but the next part, gap number D, is it dash or relative? It is also an interrogative form. To make up the demand or meaning of the sentence, we need an adjective form that will express general, mass, or embracing all. Repeat again. To make up the demand of the sentence or meaning of the sentence, here we need an adjective form. And this adjective will express general, mass, or embracing all. According to the context, is it dash or relative? According to the context, the meaningful adjective will be universal. Besides this, we can also use common, etc. Is it universal or relative? Is it common or relative? The next sentence, is it dependent on our sense dash note of interrogation? Is it dependent on our sense? If we analyze the gap number E, this is also a form of an interrogative sentence. It also expresses feeling or realization. Is it dependent on our sense dash? It is also a feeling or realization. According to the context, a meaningful noun form is needed here. Is it dependent on our sense dash? And this noun will precise range of sense organs and the suitable noun form will be perceptions. Perceptions. Dear learners, point remember that. Is it dependent on our sense dash note of interrogation? This is also an interrogative sentence. It also expresses feeling or realization. According to the context, a meaningful noun form is needed here. That will precise range of sense organs. And the suitable noun will be perception. Beside this, we can also use an adjective form only. And it is also meaningful for this sentence. If we say, is it dependent on our sense only? It also correct answer. So, beside noun form perceptions, we can use here an adjective only. Okay? Next sentence, does it lie in the dash of the beholder? Note of interrogation. This is also an interrogative sentence. This sentence opens with does, that is verb to do, and it is also interrogative form. According to the context, for expressing visualization or noticing, a meaningful noun form is needed here. And the suitable noun form will be I. Does it lie in the eye of the beholder? Beside this, we can also use sense or sight, etc. Does it lie in the eye of the beholder, or does it lie in the sense of beholder, or does it lie in the sight of the beholder? Anything is okay for this answer, but remember that it also express, it also express visualization or noticing thing that we can see in this sentence. Next one, thus there will arise a number of dash in our mind. Thus there will arise a number of dash in our mind. If we analyze the gap number Z, we will see before gap number Z, preposition of is used here, and we know after preposition there will be a meaningful noun form. According to the context or according to the meaning of the sentence, thus there will arise a number of dash in our mind, in our mind. According to the context, for expressing investigation or inquiry, investigation or inquiry, the suitable noun form will be questions. So, in favor of gap number Z, the answer will be questions. Thus, there will arise a number of questions in our mind. However, poets, artists, philosophers, and thinkers dash always in search of beauty in their works and arts. According to the meaning of the sentence, poets, artists, philosophers, and thinkers always. In the sentence here is also used always, and it also indicates the present tense. And according to the meaning of the sentence, it is simply a present indefinite tense or present perfect tense. And its subject, poets, artists, philosophers, and thinkers are also a plural form. Dear learners, you know, if subject is plural, verb will be plural. So, according to the subject, poets, artists, philosophers, and thinkers, plural form, according to the subject, the suitable verb will be in present tense. Or, if we identify as a present perfect tense, the verb will be have been. However, poets, artists, philosophers, and thinkers are always in search of beauty in their works and arts. Or, poets, artists, philosophers, and thinkers have been always in search of beauty in their works and arts. Okay, my dear students, next sentence, but most of them have the common and undisputed opinion that where there is beauty, there is dash. That is, a thing of beauty is joy dash full stop. It's a long sentence. If we analyze the sentence, we will see there are two gaps. Gap number I and J are seen here. If we analyze the gap number I, according to the meaning of the sentence, for expressing authenticity or nature, a noun form is needed here. Repeat again, for expressing authenticity or nature, a noun form is also needed here. And the suitable noun form for the gap number I will be truth or pleasure. Or pleasure. PLEASURE. Dear learners, point to remember that for expressing authenticity, we use truth or pleasure. But most of them have the common and undisputed opinion that where there is beauty, there is truth. That is, a thing of beauty is joy forever. According to the context, for expressing ever since or A-Y-E-I, there is truth. That is, a thing of beauty is joy forever. Forever means I. A-Y-E-I. I means permanently or forever or ever since. So, the meaning of the sentence, where there is beauty, there is truth. That is, a thing of beauty is joy forever. Forever. In this way, dear learners, you will complete the blank part, that is close test with clues and without clues. I think from my discussion, you will be able to know the technique and method of rules of close test with clues and without clues. And that is the end of my speech. No more today. For the time being, in conclusion, please speak the truth. It is very nice moment with you. I can certainly hope that you will able to understand everything. Remember that practice makes man perfect. So I earnestly request to my beloved students to practice more and more. If I made any unintentional mistakes, or if you fail to understand any points from my discussion, please comment on it. I shall try my best to solve your problems in the next class. Stay safe, stay with your book. Together, we will overcome this global pandemic. Thank you very much. Thank you all. Allah bless.